So very good morning to one and all. On behalf of IGNO Regional Center Cochin, myself, Dr. Prasita Unnikrishnan, Assistant Director, warmly welcome you all to this Innovation Club activity, which is called the Open Session Come Enrichment Session. In fact, the Innovation Club at Regional Center Cochin was initiated under the encouragement of the National Center for Innovation in Distance Education. In distance education, wherein a series of monthly lectures identified as enrichment session have been held at Regional Center Cochin. In fact, we have been holding this session since September 2018. And the sessions are usually held. And the sessions are usually held with an objective to enrich and generate awareness amongst the learners of IGNO on a wide range of topics, ranging from career management, MOOCs, e-support services of IGNO, ICT interventions, environmental issues. Even the last month, the session which we had held was on time management with an ODL perspective. And the recordings of the past few sessions have already been uploaded in our IGNO Regional Center Cochin YouTube channel. And I would request all learners to kindly view our earlier sessions as well, which are already uploaded. The links are also being shared to all of you in the chat box. So you can view those sessions and be benefited from these sessions. So I warmly welcome you again on behalf of IGNO Regional Center Cochin. Today we have a very learned resource person with us, Dr. V.T. Jalja Kumari. I would be giving a brief about the resource person. But before I introduce the resource person to all of you, I would like to request our regional director, Dr. J.S. Dorothy Madam, under whose guidance and leadership we are organizing the sessions every time. So I request Dorothy ma'am to kindly address you all.
Friends, I just want to get across that admissions for Indira Gandhi National Open University July 2020 session is on. And you may ask, already I'm a student, what to do? You can do some certificate course which will add on your qualification for the job market. And this small courses which will be of use to any discipline people are CHR, Certificate in Human Rights, Certificate in Functional English. These two as of now, because 6 months a certificate course will start. And so suppose you are a degree holder and it's 3 year program. By the time you complete this 3 year program, you can do 6 certificate programs. So these two common are very easy and they have only less number of subjects in it. And it is already some of the human rights you will be knowing of what is your rights. So how it can be used in a public space, it can also help you to be a skillful person in that aspect. And certificate of functional English. Nowadays, everybody, in spite of graduate having the qualification to ability to speak English, still the employer insists on some qualification. So it is somewhat equal, less than your English speaking in your 12th standard, but still it covers of what has to be covered in a workspace, in education, and besides the basic grammar. So please be benefited of these two program. And also, friends, we take this opportunity to introduce the Swayam courses of the Government of India. If you just open your Gmail account and then click www.swayam.gov.in, it will take you to the Swayam portal. There you should you can see all courses, including those courses offered by Indira Gandhi National Open University as small credit based courses, which can easily be enrolled without payment of fees. But if you want a certification and to write the proctored examination, you need to pay the fee. So just be benefited and take home message from this introduction is, how much ever you study, still there is scope for you to study, and there are opportunities for you to study. To start with, there are certificate programs of IGNU and also the SWAYAM courses if you are interested in online study, online courses. So over to Dr. Prasitha Unnikrishnan, who will introduce the guest for today. And even though the guest is also a part of us, still please introduce the guest and also the session. And we'll be available for discussion at the end of the, after the presentation by the expert. And we also want two learners to be ready to say thank you. This is one way to develop you of how to say thank you in a, for an online course. You have to switch on your mic and you have to say who you are, what program you are studying, and register the name of the expert who is talking, the topic being spoken, and say a few words of how you are benefited. That's how you say a thank you to an expert in an online session. Over to Dr. Prasitha Unnikrishnan, please.
Thank you, Dorothy ma'am. Thank you for your kind words. So now I would just like to give a brief about today's session. The today's session is on the topic COVID-19, review of personal accountability towards precautions. And very happy to introduce our colleague, Dr. V.T. Jalajakumari, to all of you. She is one of our friends and a colleague of ours, a part of this IGNU Regional Center Cochin as well. A very prolific speaker, I must say, and who has made her mark in a number of academic areas. And she was basically, she is basically an education expert and specializes in Malayalam, psychology, education, educational technology. And in fact, she has four post-graduation degrees as well to her credit, apart from the PhD. So we have a very learned and a prolific speaker in Dr. V.T. Jalajakumari. And we all are privileged to have her speaking to us for this session and to be addressing you all. So I sincerely hope that all learners would listen to her attentively, and by the end of the session, you can also have some ideas or a take-home message for all of you to carry forward from this session. And this session at least should bring about some minute change in your life, as well as you can also share this message to others as well. So a very warm welcome to Jalaja ma'am for the session, and I request her to kindly take over for the session from here on. Jalaja ma'am.
Yes, Prasitha ma'am.
Yeah, please ma'am.
Yes. So, good morning to all of you. Am I audible and visible to you?
Yes, ma'am, you're audible and visible as well.
It is better to remove my mask because I am alone in this room.
Yeah, please, please, ma'am. Please.
It's okay. Thank you very much. So, all the Innovation Club meetings were focusing on some strong areas which is needed for our further learning or to be resolved in the scenario of our education, the duration of our education or some other matters. This time we know the most important thing always we are going through, always we are thinking, always we are bothered about the pandemic only. That is, the matter is pandemic only. So last year, this time, we were thinking that in 2020-21, we will be safe, we will be free, and we will be able to go freely everywhere. We can, students were thinking that they can go to school like that. Everywhere people had an expectation like that. Now, at least some people, they are thinking and they are perceiving that sometimes we have to go like this for some more, not some more days, but some more years, to completely avoid or to be free completely in from this pandemic. This is what our situation nowadays. So anyway, for that, all of us have to cooperate with the health organizations, the government, and the people who are working hard behind this to protect us. I think it is better to have a thought or have a rethinking on this particular scenario, how we all are being accountable in this particular case or this in particular pandemic to overcome that. So I am remembering with much proud that our Chief Minister Sri Pinarayi Vijayan, when he was telling that the government is getting ready to face the third wave, immediately he was telling the third wave won't come voluntarily. It is coming through us only. Means it is created by us only. We have to think. First wave has over, second wave terribly again over. We cannot say that it is over. It's a little bit calmly it is going on. So we don't know at what time it will again spread as more terribly than the second wave and the third. And here I say is there, some researches are also there that the third wave will be affecting our youngest generation. That will be a horrible situation if our children are affected. Because if old age people are affected, I think the consequences we can comparatively. I am not saying that it is not a problem, but comparatively, the youngsters are affecting is more terrible than the aged people. But comparatively to this youngsters, so the small if. Small children are affected, it will be more difficult and more dangerous to our generation, because a long life is ahead before them. They are the real energy and source of our nation. If the consequences of long-term consequences of COVID-19 is still being among them, definitely, no doubt, our creativity, our manpower, our labor power, and labor force, everything will be in a dilemma in future. So we have to take that much precautions to avoid. Don't think that I have escaped. Like that we don't think. It is our responsibility to protect ourselves and others. In such a scenario, we have to think about this topic, personal accountability on COVID-19 pandemic, and this personal accountability towards the precautions. I have given the topic as a review on personal accountability towards precautions. Why we are trying to make a review on that? We have to make reviews on everything, because a self thinking and self-perception review is needed in this scenario. How each one is facing this particular virus and the pandemic, and how we are being a catalyst. We cannot say that catalyst, because we are making our involvement in that, and the action is taken place in us also. So we cannot simply say that it is catalyst. If the catalyst is always being there and it is reinforcing something, but personally the catalyst doesn't have is happening nothing is happened to the catalyst. That is what in chemical reaction, but that is why I have changed that terminology. So that is the relevance of thinking of personal accountability. So I think it is better to focus on the presentation, then I can say a lot of things instead of this general talk. Share it once. Just a minute. You can share the. screen is visible now. Prasida madam?
Yes ma'am, yes ma'am, screen is visible ma'am. You can just make it full screen ma'am.
Yeah, yeah, that'll. Visible now?
Yes ma'am, now it is visible.
Okay. So our topic today is COVID-19, a review of personal accountability towards precautions. So we should know what is precaution. I think the most educable thing and studied phenomena recently is COVID-19 only. The remote areas of people, the illiterates, even a person who doesn't have any school experience knows something. COVID-19, that terminology they know, coronavirus they know, social distancing they have had, mask they know, and a lot of things they know. Quarantine, isolation, like that. Hundreds of terminologies now people are aware of. These terminologies and they are hearing, and without any further knowledge, most of the people are familiar with the terminologies in this. We know what are the accountability of what is the accountability of precautions from the part of the government. I think especially Kerala is the most transparent. Kerala is the state which is having most transparent activities and information regarding COVID compared to the other states of India or any other place. I think some nations, they were not revealing the cases also, especially in Arabic countries. But our attitude, our vision, our views, everything is different than other states. So every day the government itself is giving a clear cut, almost clear cut information regarding COVID-19, the spread of COVID-19, the number of affected persons, the number of cured people, and what all facilities we are having, what all difficulties we are having, what type of precautions we have to take. Like that, our government's most important agenda in their programs are being going are focusing on COVID-19, luckily. So I think other than that of any people from any part of India, Kerala people are more aware than this one. But one question arises before us. We are aware of many things, but are we following all these awareness patterns we have acquired from the government or from books or from any other field? That is what. Government is doing a lot of things. That is, comply with the REIT's COVID-19 vaccine requirements. Sometimes other states are far ahead than us, especially in India. Maharashtra is the state where more number of vaccination held. I don't know what are the reasons, maybe some other technical reasons or policy reasons. Anyway, Kerala is also trying to overcome that. Daily health check. In this case, Kerala is the first one. So the cases, health check cases or COVID case checks are done, checks are done in Kerala than any other states, and they are clearly declaring the number of cases. That is why before many other states, the number of COVID cases or affected cases are reported from Kerala. It doesn't mean that other states are having very less number of COVID cases. No, the checking is very little, and the declaration is not that much transparent. That may be one of the reasons. And this is what researchers and people who are studying the case is always revealing the case, that Kerala is best in revealing cases transparently among the other states of India. Then basic hygiene. In that case also, I think in personal hygiene also we are, but some gaps are there that we will check. And again, this is what the government is taking accountability in their part, and they are trying to spread awareness on our personal hygiene, social hygiene and domestic hygiene, so many other things. We know that now all Sundays, Kerala government is suggesting that all Sundays have to be considered as a dry day. So everywhere, all you can corner of our state, people have to engage with cleanliness works, and we have to make our surroundings and home dry to protect our health from dengue fever like that, because this is the period of monsoon. So basic hygiene awareness programs are done by government, like that COVID-19 testing as directed. Then contact tracing, that is, you know that if they are telling that there are 432 cases are cases have been found on particular day in a particular district, 431 is through contact, how they can? So contact tracing is also going like that. Then only they can find it out from isolated cases, how isolated are or rare cases are. Okay, if this is coming from your this is affected from a person who has reached here from some other foreign countries or from other abroad countries, then only they can check on that what kind of cat or what category of virus is affected like that. So this contact tracing is very important. Then report and respond to symptoms of COVID-19. This is what we have told earlier. Then isolation of quarantine requirements. Isolation or quarantine requirements. Now, this isolation and quarantine is happening almost in our own houses only. But if the disease is more severe or some other complications are there, they are always advised and they are taken out from the home and they will be admitted in the hospitals and good treatments are given. So oxygen the cases, nothing is being reported now in our state. In our state, very nicely the health department is managing everything. And this is by WHO direction, all states are following all these things, and sometimes comparatively some variations will be there among states, that's okay, but all are doing. This is the accountability of government. Then what is personal accountability? So whatever things are going on from the side of government, parallelly all the people have to be cooperated, have to be involved in the process of protection from or precautions of COVID-19. Follow the precautions of COVID-19. That is what I mean by personal accountability. You know by the terminology what is personal accountability. Each member has an individual responsibility to help and prevent the spread of coronavirus. That is what personal accountability we mean. The first thing is protect yourself and others, or protect ourselves and others. Protect people and others means if I am safe, if I don't have this coronavirus, I am not a person affected by coronavirus, I can protect others. How? Because through me, that won't be reaching to any other person. So each person is taking that responsibility, not to protect yourself, but to avoid the spread of COVID to others through you. That is also one of the biggest responsibility of others. So we may always focus on these two things, protect yourself and protect others. Protect others means not only the nearest person to you. That is why again another sentence, protect people and others, means if you can be away from your family members, but at the same time you have to be away from the people outside, from the society. That is why again I have used this, protect people and others. So we don't limit our living platform into us, into our family, or into our society, office, other than that, our society outside is also to be protected by us. That is our responsibility. Then, why this personal accountability is lagging always? Maybe because of many things. Our perceptions on risk and lowered risk. Perceptions on risk is always, we can interpret that, that will lower the risk. But perceptions of risk and perception of lowered risk, both are different. Because among people, we are seeing both. Our behavior and health decisions depend on our perceptions of risk. Actions and emotions are often driven by risk perception more than factual information. So, what do you mean by this? Actions and emotions are often driven. Our actions and our emotions go ahead, or it becomes active by risk perceptions more than factual information. So every factual information is there. Everybody knows how it is affected, how it is being affected, what is the conditions, and what is the distance to be kept in between two persons. Everybody knows. This is what factual information. And the factual scientific evidences, the through our saliva or our breath, and these are the reasons. That is why we are closing nose and mouth together. We are always washing our hand. We know all these are factual informations, and these are not imaginary things. But these factual informations are not perceived. In which way you are perceiving it? If you are thinking that God is the factor for the spreading of coronavirus, I am a very big worshipper, I won't be affected by this. That is your perception. That's your perception, not fact. There is a difference between factual information and perception. That is why being more, you are a contemplator like that, or you are doing meditation, you are not doing any other precautions regarding this one, and you are believing like that. And you are thinking that I'm always at home. Our grandparents, our small children, they are always at home. And they are thinking that they are not going out. That's also a fact. But their perception is that they are not going out. So I won't be a factor for spreading coronavirus. And I won't be, never this will affect me. This is what their perception. So this is the difference between fact and perception. And perception of risk is different. There may be risk, they know about it. What are the risk factors they know? But the risk factor, how they perceive, is different. If they are perceiving in such a way, that is what the perception of risk. So there is risk, and this is riskful. Like that they are perceiving, that is perception of risk. Like that, risks are lower just because of preventive behavior. This is due to the perception of lower risk. This preventive behavior only makes a catalyst or a factor to make the risk lower. That is also. So lowering a risk and increasing a risk, both have to be perceived in a good way, in a proper way. Otherwise, people cannot be the part of the prevention, or cannot be the part of the people who are preventing the spread of COVID. So perception and facts, both are different, but both are related. So whatever may be the factual information, our perception on risk and perception in lowered risk have to be considered in the spread of COVID-19. That is the main issue. So whenever we are telling somebody, please, you put the mask properly, they may reply, we know. We are not asking what you know, but what you do. That is the thing. Everybody knows. And they may have justification also for that. I feel breathless, like that some may say. may be there. Just imagine the, immediately what we have to think. We have to think about the doctors who are working for us for 24 hours. The nurses, they are working for us. Other health workers working for us. How much of risk they are taking? They are using this PPE kit. I think almost all of us have been experienced, or we have seen how doctors and other health workers are wearing the mask. Three layers of mask they are using. They are using three layers of blouses, different types of blouses they are using. And they are not even able to remove the PPE kit and their mask, all these things. Even they are using a food coverage. They are not even remove it before completion of their work. So what they are doing, controlling, drinking water, taking food. So everything they are controlling, and they are suffering for us. Because once it is removed, they have to wear another one. So that is very costly, that very expensive. So what doctors are doing, they are using one set of this PPE kit and that suit. And they are stopping all their natural calls, nature's calls and everything for a long time. How much they are suffering, just imagine. Is it a pleasing experience being in a PPE kit? No. We are very much, we are facing very much difficulty to wear even a mask. In that time, our health workers, our doctors, the people who are working in the health organizations are suffering for us. So we don't say, I am not able to wear a mask. Simply a mask we are using. That also not in proper way we are using. So this is our responsibility to make others conscious about it. If we are using the proper, we are using the mask in a proper way, then only we will be able to tell others. How many of you are giving information to the people who are sitting at us? Please, you don't do like this. This is not the proper way. This way you have to do like that. How many of you have told to anybody? It is also accountability, personal accountability, our individual accountability. So teaching others, always educating others is a very big thing. That is what educated people has to do. That is why this motto is there. Teach each one, teach one. Each one, teach one is that. Sometimes if somebody is telling, we will avoid our laziness. We may be more conscious at that time. If nobody is telling, we will also think that nobody is telling and nobody is bothering about it. Then what is the problem? So let go of the thing like that. Many of the things we are doing, why? Because others are telling and others are observing. Others are watching us. So this case is also being like that. So that is a very, so the perception of risk may be like that. 3 C's everybody knows. It's by heart to all. What are the 3 C's? Crowded places, close contact settings, especially where people have conversation very near each other. We always try to minimize our speech, talk, unnecessarily don't open our mouths. That we have to practice. Definitely that we have to practice. We know Jaina sannyasis of ancient India, what they were doing, they were always using mask. Because we know that നമ്മുടെ കോടതികളിലൊക്കെ വെച്ചിരിക്കുന്ന മലയാളം അറിയാത്ത ആളുണ്ടോ? ഹലോ, മലയാളം മനസ്സിലാവാത്തവരുണ്ടോ? മലയാളം പറയാൻ വേണ്ടിയല്ല, ഇടയ്ക്കെങ്ങാണോ ഒന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു പോയാൽ അതോർത്ത് പറഞ്ഞു. ഓക്കെ, കോടതിയിൽ വെച്ചിരിക്കുന്ന ഒരു ത്രാസ് ഉണ്ട്, സന്തുലിതാവസ്ഥയിലിരിക്കുന്ന ഒരു ത്രാസ്. അത് നീതിന്യായവും ഉറപ്പുവരുത്തേണ്ടതിനെ കാണിക്കാനുള്ള ഒരു സിമ്പലാണ്. അതേപോലെ ഇറ്റ് വാസ് എ സിമ്പൽ വെൻ ദ ജൈന സന്യാസിൻസ് വെർ യൂസിങ് മാസ്ക്. ബിക്കോസ് അവർ ബേർഡ്സ് ഓൾവേസ് words are very important, you know. If once we have told something unnecessarily or irritable to others, we cannot take it back. That is the mark we are making others about us. People are remembering us, people are loving us, first with our words, first because of our words. Whatever good deeds we are doing, if our words are not good, others won't like us. No doubt. Sometimes we are doing a lot of good things, but our words are very bad. People won't accept us. They won't like, love us. So word is the primary constraint in love. People are loving us first from our words, then only other things comes. No doubt. So in symbolically, to control words, to control speech, China sannyasins were using mask. And this was all this, now it is an essential thing. So some people, even though we are highly educated, when we are speaking to someone, immediately what we are doing, we are lowering our mask. Don't do that, please. Don't do that. When you start to speak, you put it upward. You cover at that time your mouth and nose. Then only you speak to others. So it is very bad if you are lowering your mask while speaking. If you are not using mask, that itself is a big problem. That is the first thing. And second thing is removing mask from your proper place. That is not good. Second thing, if you are seeing somebody like that, please tell. Cheta, mask shirikvikyu. I wonder what will happen. Do you know, I was coming to this office by bus. Not now, I was. No, recently, I'm coming by car. But before that, for almost 9-10 months, I was coming to this office by bus. And for years, I was doing that practice. How I was coming, you cannot imagine. And nobody was identifying me even. I'm putting a cloth on my head and I am covering almost all part, and I am using mask, specs, gloves, like that I was traveling, and I didn't even open my mouth in the bus, only for taking a ticket or something. And every day I am coming in the same bus, so they know where I have to go, where I will get down. So that amount is coming waiting. And if a little bit of balance is there, I am telling that tomorrow I will manage. I was not taking back it, because I didn't want to have that money with me. This is what happens. And what I was doing, even if they are giving me the balance, if I am getting money from any place, what I am doing, I will take that money and I am keeping it in a particular cover, and immediately reaching home, I will put it in Dettol water. For 5 minutes, I will put it in Dettol water and I will put safely in a general window stream. But our note is very nice. Now only I understood that our currency is very good. Because how many times we are doing it, no issue, nothing will happen. And it will be very clean, neat and stiff after doing this one. So this was practice. This is being practiced from 20th of March 2020. Not 22nd of March 2020 onwards, I am practicing this till time. Whenever I am purchasing something from outside, I am coming to that precautionary measures of domestic precautionary measures. Before that, let me close. So, confined and enclosed spaces. So, avoid crowded places. Close contact settings you avoid, especially where people have conversation. That is what the speech I taught. Very near each other. And confined and enclosed spaces with the poor ventilation, avoid. These three things have to be avoided. That is what I have given in a tutorial form. Everybody know, everywhere we are hearing and seeing this only. And what is the gap between when the personal account, this is what personal account is. There only gaps happens. We have our overconfidence that I won't be affected. And we are thinking that I didn't go outside, then how it will come? we are taking a particular packet from outside. We are taking a packet from outside. Definitely, we are not sure whether it is the virus is there on the packet. So don't be overconfident. Then unscientific beliefs and measures. That's what I told. I am a very devotee, so I won't be affected like that. No, it is not like that. Nowadays, we are not able to even worship in temples, churches, and mosques. We cannot go there. So that is there. Laziness to follow precautions. And once we are thinking that, yesterday onwards I have a feel of fever. I am thinking that somewhere if I am affected like that, I have taken two vaccination. But even though I am thinking that, because I am strictly following everything, even though I am thinking that if I had something without washing like that, I am thinking. So laziness, if we are taking, we are doing, we are showing laziness to follow the precaution, sometimes that loophole is enough. One incident is enough to affect, to be affected. So don't show laziness to wash our hands like that. Difficulty to cope up with the challenging situation. Some people are always telling, how I will sit at home always? How I will be at home always? I cannot. So don't show that difficulty, because we never experienced such a scenario in our life. And this is life-threatening scenario. Don't challenge it. So don't show difficulty to cope up with the precautions. Think of health-related workers. Then you will get a little bit relaxed. So attitude towards change of prolonged practices. Now people are telling that, എത്ര നാളായി ഇങ്ങനെ ഇരിക്കുന്നേ, എത്ര നാളായി ഉള്ളേ എന്ന് വെച്ചാൽ അത്രയും നാളിരിക്കണം. Now people are thinking that. So the duration, the long duration വരുന്നത്, you don't make a negative attitude towards being somewhere or being at home for long time. Do your work from home. It's very difficult, I know. A lot of problems are there with us for being at home. Especially men, our social system has taught a lot of things among the men population of our country. So because the household things are done by ladies only. So what has to be done by the men? A lot of things are there. At least once you practice, what is the difficulty of your wife? What is the difficulty of your mother? How your mother was procuring all of these things for this much of time? You just experience, then you will have a feel of love towards them. Instead of that, drinking at home, killing ladies for dowry system and everything, this is not a good practice. So nowadays, violence is also growing because of corona. So they were not at home. They were somewhere. Now, being at home makes them difficult, and their behavioral patterns are being changed. So always struggle is strife and conflict is there in between men and women. Especially husband and wife. They are thinking that if I were in the office, like that they are thinking, no. Or I were in the field, even daily workers are also like that. When they are at home, then only issues are arising. They are, but in their absence, the ladies at home, they were managing everything at that time, nothing was there. So be with them, cooperate with them for the household things. There is, household works are endless works. Nobody knows. Men never knows it. Every day we have to clean. Every day we have to wash. Every day we have to cook. Several times we have to cook. Several times we have to wash the utensils. Several times we have to clean the house. How many? How? I think in normal houses, there is no end for domestic works. Be the part of that. Give a little bit time for them to enjoy and to relax. Let them see us in film. Let them see television sometime. Let them be with you for good things. Help them. Then your time will, at that time, you will understand that. Sitting at home is not a difficult thing. It is not a task at all, because a lot of things we have to do there. How much of maintenance work is there at your home? And plant trees or plant plants, do that, or cultivate some other vegetables in your home like that, you do something. So change your attitude and don't think that this is the responsibility of the government only. No, this is your responsibility also, one's estimate. So lack of sustenance of non-behavioral patterns. This is the final thing I have to tell. This is the lack of sustenance of new behavioral patterns. This is a new behavioral pattern. Now we are experiencing a new behavioral pattern. So we cannot sustain it. Don't be miserable with that. So please pop up with the new situations and make the habit of new behavioral patterns. Otherwise, we cannot survive. That is one thing. How it is spread? This is Paka scientific. We should know that. We know that the disease is caused by the SARS-CoV-2 virus, which spreads people in several different ways. And now mutated forms are also there. So that is the headache of the government and health workers. The virus can spread from an infected person's mouth or nose in small liquid particles when they cough, sneeze, speak, sing, or breathe. These particles range from larger respiratory droplets to smaller aerosols. So the smaller aerosols will also remain in the atmosphere for some time. So if a person, if you are entering to a room where somebody was there earlier for last half an hour, he went out. Immediately we are thinking that we can enter to the room and we can be there. No problem is there because nobody is there. But the place was utilized by another person who was affected, you just imagine. His aerosols will be there in the atmosphere. If you are going there and breathing it without a mask, it will reach in your lungs, mouth, and your respiratory system. No doubt, that we doesn't know. That's why we are always telling that we will be very much patient and peacefully we are thinking that nobody is there in the room. If the room was utilized by some other person, that room is not safe. So that is why we are telling that avoid crowded place. If all are sitting simply, even though there may be these things, purely ventilated indoor locations and avoid prolonged contact with others. If we are in contact with 15 minutes, contact with a person for 15 minutes, definitely that will be affected. It's clear. Because people are getting it. Spend more time outdoor than indoor. So farming is a very good thing to spend time because they are outdoor. Ventilation is important. Open windows when indoors to increase the amount of outdoor air. So this aerosols will go out with the flow of the wind. Do for that. Avoid touching surfaces. That is unnecessarily, you will see when you are going to super shops. Supermarkets. People are simply going, even they are taking a milk cover. I have seen it and I told them. If they don't want that thing, don't touch on that. Did you listen anywhere? Did you listen? If you are going to a market, you think if one person has reached and touched on a particular thing, don't take that thing. You avoid that. And you insist to the persons who are in the shop to take and give. At least one person is touching. Is it? If all the people coming from outside are touching and testing and putting there, and then they are going, why they are unnecessarily touching on that? You have to discourage people. So that is why surface cleaning is needed every day. Somebody is coming and putting something. Even in offices, files, we cannot say that. Many people are touching on that, it is coming. And the papers including in the file is handled by many people. So don't use like that. Frequently clean your hands with soap water and alcohol-based hand rub. That is why. In many flavors, we are getting hand washes now. It's beautiful to see, beautiful to smell, very affordable to smell, but it doesn't mean that it is useful. Or the alcoholic content is included in the prescribed manner. So use hand-rub things alcoholic based and use often it. Cover your cuffs and sneezes with a bent elbow or tissue. Tissue is better. Bent elbow is, I people are telling like this, but I think bent elbow is protecting us. But our elbow, if we are doing like that, our bent elbow will be affected, and that will be, sometimes it will go outside. So always use tissue, and don't put that tissue somewhere. You dispose it in a safe manner, throwing used tissues in a closed bin right away. Then wash your hands or use an alcohol-based hand rub. Get vaccinated. So many people, they are reluctant to vaccinate. They are telling that for simple reasons. Medical precautions are there. So the people who are using aspirin and some allergic issues, means the severe allergic issues, they don't be vaccinated. Like that, medical people, they themselves are safe. But others, wait, if the thing is going out, then we will be escaped from vaccination. No, there is no problem for vaccination. So correct education regarding this one. If somebody is telling you like that, you scientifically tell them this is one, because you are learned people. Follow all the local guidance and recommendations about the vaccination. So also people may be infected by touching surfaces, then be contaminated by the virus with the touching their eyes. That is what we have a habit of touching on our eyes, nose, mouth. And how we are using this mask, you know, this is the mask I have utilized. I have closely used it, and this way I am using it. People are always touching on that, and they are putting up what? Why? Because it is not tight. Use a proper one, a tight one, then don't touch on that. If you are touching on that, the affected things will be there outside. If you are always holding on that, your hand will be affected. And you are touching on that, and you are touching on others, and the touched things will be handed over to others. If you are taking this, you don't touch this part. You take this, close it. Like that you do it. If you are using an N95 mask, I think the N95 mask is, they are holding this person before you, this portion, and putting it, and this strips will be put like this. Not they are touching inside the mask. So that is also there. You don't put your mask simply on table where some others have touched. You don't do that. When you take it for sometimes, here this room is a vacant room, I am using this, and you close it and closely you put it. You don't open this inside portion and put it somewhere. Like that you do it. And immediately after that, you have to do a lot of things. And when it is suggested, you don't think that the symptoms are, when a person is affected by coronavirus, after the infection, it is contaminated or it is infected to others before they show the symptoms. So that is the dangerous situation. We don't think that if ഇന്നലെയാണ് അയാൾക്ക് പനി വന്നത് അല്ലെ ഇന്നലെയാണ് അയാൾക്ക് ഉണ്ടെന്ന് സ്ഥിരീകരിച്ചത് ഞാൻ അതിനു മുമ്പെയാണ് അയാളുമായിട്ട് കോണ്ടാക്റ്റിൽ ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നത് അതുകൊണ്ട് എനിക്ക് വന്നിട്ടുണ്ടാവില്ല എന്ന് വിചാരിക്കരുത് അയാൾ സിംറ്റംസ് കാണിക്കുന്നതിന് മുമ്പാണ് സ്പ്രെഡ് ആവുക അപ്പൊ നമുക്ക് തന്നതിന് ശേഷമാണ് അയാളെ സിംറ്റംസ് വരുന്നത് അതുകൊണ്ട് ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ദ ടൈം ഫോർ ബീയിങ് അഫക്റ്റഡ് അതുകൂടെ വിചാരിക്കുക സോ ഇതൊക്കെ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് അറിയാവുന്ന കാര്യങ്ങളാണ് അതുകൊണ്ട് നമ്മൾ 1 മീറ്റർ 2 മീറ്റർ ഷോർട്ടേജ് ഡിസ്റ്റൻസിലെ നിൽക്കാവുള്ളൂ അത്രയും സ്ഥലത്ത് ഈ പാർട്ടിക്കിൾസ് നമ്മുടെ സ്പീച്ചിൻ്റെ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ സലൈവ പാർട്ടിക്കിൾസ് സസ്റ്റെയിൻ ചെയ്യുമെന്നും ഒക്കെ നിങ്ങൾക്കറിയാം അതൊക്കെ ഞാൻ പറഞ്ഞു അപ്പം അതൊക്കെ നിങ്ങൾ ഓർക്കുക ഡൊമസ്റ്റിക് സ്ട്രാറ്റജീസ് നമുക്ക് സ്വന്തമായിട്ട് ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റുന്ന കുറേ കാര്യങ്ങൾ നോക്കൂ ഈ 3 C's ആദ്യം ഫോളോ ചെയ്യുക പിന്നെ ഒക്കറൻസസ് ഓഫ് വിസിറ്റ് ഔട്ട്സൈഡ് വളരെ കുറയ്ക്കുക കടയിൽ സാധനം മേടിക്കാൻ പോകുകയാണെങ്കിൽ യു ഗോ വൺസ് ആൻഡ് പർച്ചേസ് ദ നീഡഡ് തിങ്സ് ഒരു ലിസ്റ്റ് എടുക്കുക ആൻഡ് പർച്ചേസ് ദ നീഡഡ് തിങ്സ് യു ഡോണ്ട് ഗോ 3 times ഇൻ a day, please. Ipo restriction onnum illa, you can go at any time, but don't go to the shops. You don't purchase the provisions from the nearby shops only. Korchu dooreyk povaru, kan kooduthal aalukal വന്ന് ഇടപെടുന്ന സ്ഥലങ്ങളിലേക്ക് പോകാൻ ഇടവരാതെ നിയർ ബൈ ഷോപ്സ് ഒലി യു ഗോ ആൻഡ് അവോയ്ഡ് സെലക്ടിങ് തിങ്സ് ഫ്രോം ദ ഷോപ്സ് യു ഡോണ്ട് ടച്ച് ഓൺ എനി ഓഫ് ദ തിങ്സ് കെപ്റ്റ് ഇൻ ദ ഷോപ്പ് യു ടെൽ ദ ഷോപ്പ് കീപ്പർ ദേ വിൽ പ്രൊവൈഡ് യു തിങ്സ് അറ്റ്ലീസ്റ്റ് ദാറ്റ് പേഴ്സൺ ക്യാൻ പ്രിവെന്റ് ബിക്കോസ് ഹി ക്യാൻ വാഷ് ചോദിക്കണം ചേട്ടാ കൈയൊക്കെ കഴുകുന്നുണ്ടോ പിന്നെ കടയുടെ മുന്നിൽ ഒരു സ്പ്രിംഗ് ഒക്കെ കെട്ടി റോപ്പ് കെട്ടി പ്രിവെന്റ് ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ ദാറ്റ് ടൈപ്പ് ഓഫ് ഷോപ്സ് ആർ ബെറ്റർ ഗോ ദെയർ ഇഫ് സംബഡി ഈസ് പർച്ചേസിംഗ് സംതിങ് വെയിറ്റ് എ ലിറ്റിൽ ബിറ്റ് എവേ ആഫ്റ്റർ ഹിസ് പർച്ചേസ് കംപ്ലീഷൻ യു ഗോ ദെയർ ആൻഡ് ഡോണ്ട് ബി ദെയർ യു ആർ തിങ്കിങ് ദാറ്റ് സം അദർ പേഴ്സൺ വിൽ കം സോ ഐ ഹാവ് ടു ബി ദെയർ ഫസ്റ്റ് അറ്റ്ലീസ്റ്റ് എ സെക്കൻഡ് നോ ദിസ് ഇസ് നോട്ട് ദ ടൈം ഓഫ് കോമ്പറ്റീഷൻ This is not the time for competition. We are competing for being alive. Think about it. And online purchase, you maximize online purchase. When you are receiving an online packet, first sanitize your hand, cut the box with a scissor, and burn the outside cover immediately. Keep the inside thing somewhere more time. If it is a thing, which is sanitizable, sanitize. അപ്പോൾ എൻ്റെ ഒരു എക്സ്പീരിയൻസ് പറഞ്ഞാൽ ഞങ്ങൾ വീട്ടിൽ വാങ്ങിക്കുന്ന ബ്രെഡ് കവർ വരെ പതിയെ ടാപ്പിൻ്റെ കീഴിൽ സൂക്ഷ്മമായിട്ട് പിടിച്ചിട്ട് സോപ്പ് പതിയെ തൂത്ത് വെച്ച് വെച്ച് മൈൽഡായിട്ട് സോപ്പ് തൂത്ത് വെള്ളം ഒഴിച്ച് കഴുകി കളഞ്ഞ് വെച്ച് കൊണ്ടുവന്ന് ഫാനിൻ്റെ അടിയിൽ വയ്ക്കും തുണി വെച്ച് തുടയ്ക്കും തുടച്ചിട്ട് ഫാനിൻ്റെ അടിയിൽ ഡൈനിങ് ടേബിളിൽ വയ്ക്കും ഒന്ന് ഡ്രൈ ആയി കഴിഞ്ഞ് മാത്രം ഓപ്പൺ ചെയ്യുക അത് പാക്ക് ചെയ്ത് വരുന്നത് മെഷീൻ പാക്കിംഗ് ആയതുകൊണ്ട് അവിടെ ഹാൻഡ് ടച്ച് ഇല്ല This way you can be safe. പച്ചക്കറി കഴുകി വാരി വെക്കുന്നത് വെക്കാവുന്ന ചില സാധനങ്ങളിൽ ക്യാരറ്റ് ഒക്കെ കഴുകി വെച്ചാൽ പെട്ടെന്ന് ചീഞ്ഞു പോകും അങ്ങനെ കഴുകുവാണെങ്കിൽ തുടച്ചിട്ട് എടുത്ത് വയ്ക്കും അതല്ല എങ്കിൽ അത് കുക്ക് ചെയ്യാൻ വെജിറ്റബിൾ കട്ടിങ്ങിന് വെൻ യു ആർ ടേക്കിംഗ് ഇറ്റ് ഔട്ട് സൈഡ് യു ടേക്ക് ഇറ്റ് വെയിൽ ഇറ്റ് ഇമ്മീഡിയറ്റ്ലി യു വാഷ് യുവർ ഹാൻഡ് വിത്ത് സോപ്പ് ഇൻ ബിറ്റ്വീൻ യു ഡോണ്ട് ടച്ച് ഓൺ യുവർ ഫേസ് ഐ എം ടെല്ലിംഗ് സ്പെഷ്യലി ഫോർ ലേഡീസ് ഹു ആർ ഡൂയിങ് ലൈക്ക് So take care. This is a time for carefulness. Take care always. Milk in the cover, you can take it in the freezer. Because freezing is good for this virus. Fridge is a very acceptable place for this. Pleasant place for virus. Virus is not in the freezer. Minus many degrees. That's why ഫ്രീസ് ചെയ്യാൻ വെക്കുന്നതിന് മുമ്പ് യു വാഷ് ഇറ്റ് വിത്ത് സോപ്പ് എപ്പോഴും പിന്നെ സിങ്കിൻ്റെ അവിടെ വെച്ചിരിക്കും സോപ്പ് അതിൻ്റെ പുറത്തുകൂടെ പതപ്പിച്ച് നല്ലോണം ഇങ്ങനെ വെച്ചിട്ട് റബ് ചെയ്തിട്ട് തിരിച്ചു മറിച്ച് നല്ലോണം ടാപ്പ് റണ്ണിങ് ടാപ്പിൽ അത് കഴുകി കളഞ്ഞിട്ട് മാത്രം എടുത്ത് ഫ്രീസറിലേക്ക് പാലിൻ്റെ കവർ വയ്ക്കുക നിങ്ങൾക്ക് നമുക്ക് ശ്രദ്ധിക്കാൻ പറ്റും ഇതെല്ലാം റൂട്ടാണ് മാക്സിമൈസ് ഓൺലൈൻ പർച്ചേസ് വാഷ് ഓർ സാനിറ്റൈസ് ബിഫോർ യൂസ് മാക്സിമൈസ് കടയിൽ നിന്ന് വാങ്ങുന്ന സാധനങ്ങൾ പച്ചയ്ക്ക് തിന്നുന്നത് സ്വഭാവം ഇപ്പം വേണ്ടാതിരിക്കുക ഫ്രൂട്ട്സ് മാത്രം അങ്ങനെയുള്ളൂ ഫ്രൂട്ട്സ് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ തന്നെയും സോപ്പിട്ട് കഴുകുന്നത് നല്ലതാണ് കാരണം അതിൻ്റെ മേലടിച്ചിരിക്കുന്ന പെസ്റ്റിസൈഡ്സ് വിൽ ഗോ ഔട്ട് സോ ദറ്റ് ഈസ് ബെറ്റർ പീൽ ആൻഡ് യൂസ് കഴിവതും കൊണ്ട് ഫുഡ് കഴിക്കുക ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ ചൂടോടെ കഴിക്കുക ഒരു ടെമ്പറേച്ചറിൽ കഴിക്കുക അറ്റ് 70 ഡിഗ്രി സെൻറ്റിഗ്രേഡ് ദിസ് വിൽ ഡൈ Otherwise, if you are using things as such, fruits and all, wash it and then use. പഴം പൊളിക്കുന്നത് വളരെ അധികം ശ്രദ്ധിക്കേണ്ട ഒരു കാര്യം പഴം പൊളിക്കാൻ അറിയില്ലാത്തവർക്ക് ഒരു കൈ കൊണ്ട് പഴം പൊളിക്കുമ്പോൾ പഴത്തേൽ ആ പുറത്തെ കൈ പിടിക്കുന്നതിലും കൂടെ അങ്ങനെയല്ല അത് നല്ല വൃത്തിയായിട്ട് അറിയും ഒരു കൈ കൊണ്ട് പിടിക്കുക പതിയെ പീൽ ചെയ്യുക പീൽ ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ വെൻ യു ആർ ടച്ചിങ് ഓൺ ദ പീൽ ഓഫ് ദ ബനാന ലൈക്ക് ദിസ് ഡോണ്ട് ടച്ച് ഇൻസൈഡ് എന്നിട്ട് ഇങ്ങനെ പതുക്കെ ഒന്ന് വിട്ടാൽ അത് പ്ലേറ്റിലേക്ക് വീഴും ദെൻ യു ടേക്ക് എൻ ഹാബിറ്റ് after washing your hands ഇത് പഴം ഇങ്ങനെ തൊലിയും പുറത്തേക്ക് എടുക്കും ആ കൈ കൊണ്ട് അകത്ത് പിടിച്ച് പിന്നെ എടുക്കും ആൾക്കാർ പഴം പിടിക്കും അതുപോലെ ബേസിക് തിങ്സ് ആണ് ഇതൊക്കെ വി ആർ തിങ്കിങ് ദാറ്റ് വി നോ എവറിഥിങ് ആക്ച്വലി വി ഡസന്റ് നോ സോ മെനി തിങ്സ് ആർ ദേർ സോ സാനിറ്റൈസ് കറൻസി ഈവൻ ഒരു സ്പ്രേ പാൻ സാനിറ്റൈസർ പോക്കറ്റിൽ ഇട്ടേക്കുക പൈസ എല്ലായിടത്തും തിന്നിട്ട് നേരെ പോക്കറ്റിലോട്ട് വെക്കും അതിൻ്റെ കൂടെ കണ്ണടയും വയ്ക്കും അതിനോട് സകലം തന്നെ വയ്ക്കും അവരുടെ കയ്യിൽ നിന്ന് കിട്ടുമ്പോൾ തന്നെ സ്പ്രേ ചെയ്യുക എന്നിട്ട് മടക്കി വയ്ക്കുക കണ്ണട ഒരിക്കലും അതിൻ്റെ കൂട്ടത്തിൽ വയ്ക്കാതിരിക്കുക കാരണം ഏറ്റവും വേർസ്റ്റ് തിങ് ആണ് ഇൻ ദ ലോ ഇൻ ദ വേൾഡ് മണി അതാണ് ഏറ്റവും കൂടിയ കാര്യം എങ്കിൽ പോലും വേർസ്റ്റ് തിങ് ദറ്റ് മച്ച് ഓഫ് പീപ്പിൾ ആർ handing over it. So these are the precautions to be taken for. Don't touch on your face without washing hands. Don't touch on your mask. Taking baths. Porathu poyittu vannal. Without taking bath, you don't enter and don't touch anywhere at the home. Nere bathroom ilekku poga. Dip your dress in Dettol water or soap water. എന്നിട്ട് നല്ലതായിട്ട് സോപ്പിട്ട് വെറുതെ നിന്ന സോപ്പിട്ട് നല്ലതായിട്ട് ബോഡി മുഴുവൻ റബ് ചെയ്ത് കുളിക്കുക. എന്നിട്ട് നമ്മൾ കുളിക്കുന്നതിന് മുന്നേ ഡ്രസ്സ് എടുത്തുകൊണ്ട് അങ്ങ് പോകല്ലേ കേട്ടത്. ഒന്നുകിൽ നിങ്ങൾ രാവിലെ ഡ്രസ്സ് എടുത്തിട്ട് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ വീട്ടിലാരെങ്കിലും ഡ്രസ്സ് കൊണ്ട് തരാൻ പറയുക. നമ്മളൊക്കെ എങ്ങനെയാണ് ചെയ്യുക? നമ്മളായിട്ട് കുളിച്ചിട്ട് അവിടെ റൂമിലേക്ക് കയറി ബാഗ് ഒക്കെ അങ്ങോട്ട് കൊണ്ടുവന്ന് വെച്ചിട്ട് നമ്മൾ ഷെൽഫ് തുറന്ന് ഡ്രസ്സെല്ലാം എടുത്ത് അതും കൊണ്ട് മേത്തോട്ട് വെച്ച് അങ്ങോട്ട് കൊണ്ടുപോയി. അങ്ങനെയൊന്നുമല്ല. ഡോണ്ട് ഡു ഇറ്റ് ദാറ്റ്. These are the precautions to be taken. Ingeneka nokkiya I think I hope 90% will be can idin adekkulla loopholes lokku varuvayi. For that use always mask. Okay, spread idin ithrayekka chindikkathathu kondana rural area le spread kudalana spreading families. Karanam when we are entering to home we are thinking that we are free from everything. No, we have brought it. അതുകൊണ്ടാണ് ഫാമിലി മെമ്പേഴ്സിൻ്റെ ഇടയിൽ സ്പ്രെഡ് കൂടുതലാണെന്ന് ഈ ലാസ്റ്റ് സെക്കൻഡ് വേവിൻ്റെ പഠനം അതായിരുന്നു. സ്പ്രെഡ് ഈസ് ഇൻ ദ ഫാമിലി ഇറ്റ്സെൽഫ്, നോട്ട് ഫ്രം ഔട്ട് സൈഡ്. സോ വൺ പേഴ്സൺ ഈസ് ഗോയിങ് ഔട്ട് ആൻഡ് ഓൾ അതേഴ്സ് ആർ അറ്റ് ഹോം ആൻഡ് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് അഫക്റ്റഡ് ബൈ ഓൾ അറ്റ് ഹോം. മീൻസ് വാട്ട്? ആദ്യത്തെ സ്റ്റേജിൽ ആലോചിച്ച് നോക്കൂ, ഇഫ് വൺ ഈസ് അഫക്റ്റഡ് ദാറ്റ് പേഴ്സൺ ഈസ് ബീങ് ഐസൊലേറ്റഡ് ഇൻ ദ റൂം ആൻഡ് നോബഡി എൽസ് വാസ് അഫക്റ്റഡ്. ബട്ട് ഇൻ ദ സെക്കൻഡ് വേവ് ഓൾ ദ മെമ്പേഴ്സ് ഇൻ ദ ഫാമിലി വാസ് അഫക്റ്റഡ്. വൈ? Why? Personal accountability was very less. That is why. Okay. So these are the things I had to share with you. And be more conscious and avoid the third wave. That is what my advice to you. And that is what my enrichment message to you for this session. Thank you very much for listening to me. And if you have anything to share with me, you can share. If you have any information to give me more than this, you please. Because all of us are needed like that of information. And thank you Prasidhar madam for giving me this opportunity. Thank you regional director ma'am. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you Jalja ma'am for the wonderful session which you have taken. In fact we all have a take home message from her session, I suppose, especially the 3 C's which she highlighted. That is, we should avoid closed spaces, we should avoid crowded places, and close contact settings needs to be avoided. And finally, the tips and tricks which she explained for a from her own practical experiences also, she has shared many various things wherein we can avoid a third wave by being cautious and taking the necessary precautions. So thank you Jalja ma'am for the wonderful session. Now I leave this session open to all of you. In case you have any doubts which you want to ask to our resource person, or any doubts pertaining to the EOP program also you are pursuing, please unmute your mic and please ask your query directly. We would also like to mention that the July 2021 admission cycle of IGNO is presently open for all those students who have joined here. And even to pass on this message to others, even to your family and to whomsoever you know, you can just convey this message that the July 2021 admission cycle is presently open, and those who are interested in taking any add-on program of IGNO or any program of IGNO can please take admission right now. The last date of admission is given as 15th of July 2021. and the admission session is presently open. And for all those learners who have taken admission in the January 2021 admission cycle, especially for semester-based programs like MCA and BCA, they need to presently do their re-registration. Re-registration means you are paying fees for the second semester or or your next year. So for semester-based programs, especially MCA, BCA and other programs, the students have to do re-registration right now, for which the last date is June 30th, 2021. So these are some information. And for all the updates with respect to submission of your assignments, submission of your examination form, you should routinely keep checking the IGNO website, www.igno.ac.in, from which all the latest updates are being made available to the student directly. Also, the induction guidelines for the January 2021 session is already uploaded on the Regional Center Cochin website, http://rccochin.igno.ac.in. We have given so many relevant links in the chat box. The students can take note of that. Even if you give Regional Center Cochin in the Google, you will also get our Regional Center Cochin website, through which all the latest news and updates can be made available for the students. Further, we also have our Regional Center Cochin YouTube channel, which also our students can watch, wherein in case any of you have missed the induction meeting or induction meeting video, the same is uploaded in the YouTube channel of Regional Center Cochin. So students can also take benefit of the same. So these were some information which I thought is very relevant to the students who have joined. In case you have any other questions or you want to ask anything, please feel free to ask us.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am.
Salma.
Enda peru Salma. Njan BAP CHBA Psychology Honors aanu eduthekkunnathu. Appo ഫസ്റ്റ് ഇയറിൽ പ്രാക്ടിക്കൽസ് അതിൽ കാണുന്നുണ്ട്, പക്ഷെ അതിനെക്കുറിച്ചുള്ള ഡീറ്റെയിൽസ് ഒന്നും അറിയില്ല. സ്റ്റഡി സെൻറ്ററിനുമായിട്ട് ബന്ധപ്പെടാനും പറ്റുന്നില്ല. എന്തെങ്കിലും ഒരു വഴി പറഞ്ഞുതരോ?
ബി എ പി സി പ്രാക്ടിക്കൽസ് എപ്പോഴെങ്കിലും സ്റ്റഡി സെൻറ്റർ ഷെഡ്യൂൾ ചെയ്യാന്ന് വെച്ചാൽ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് നോട്ടിഫിക്കേഷൻ വരും അതിനെപ്പറ്റി. ഓക്കെ, സൈക്കോളജിയുടെ സ്റ്റഡി സെന്റർ പ്രാക്ടിക്കൽസ് നടത്താത്തതിന്റെ മെയിൻ കാരണം ഇപ്പൊ ഒരു സിറ്റുവേഷൻ അങ്ങനെ ആയതുകൊണ്ടാണ്. കോവിഡ് സിറ്റുവേഷൻ വളരെയധികം കൂടിയോണ്ടാണ് നമുക്ക് സ്റ്റഡി സെന്റേഴ്സും റീജിയണൽ സെന്റേഴ്സും എല്ലാം ക്ലോസ്ഡ് ആയതുകൊണ്ടാണ് ഈ സിറ്റുവേഷൻ വന്നത്. അപ്പൊ അതൊന്നും നിങ്ങൾ ബെയർ ചെയ്ത് വെക്കാം. എന്തായാലും ഇത് തീർച്ചയായിട്ടും നമുക്ക് ഓവർകം ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ തീർച്ചയായിട്ടും സ്റ്റഡി സെന്റേഴ്സ് നടത്തുമായിരിക്കും, നടത്തും. ഓക്കെ, അപ്പൊ അത് നടത്തുമ്പോ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് എന്തായാലും നോട്ടിഫിക്കേഷൻ വരും. അപ്പൊ നിങ്ങൾ സ്റ്റഡി സെന്ററിന്റെ ടച്ചിൽ ഇരിക്കണം എപ്പോഴും.
ഓക്കെ മാം, ഓക്കെ, താങ്ക് യു.
എനി മോർ ഡൗട്ട്സ്? ഡോറത്തി മാം, ഇനി ആർക്കെങ്കിലും ഒരു എന്തെങ്കിലും പറയാനുണ്ടോ സെഷനിൽ? ആർക്കും റിസോഴ്സ് പേഴ്സണോട് ഒന്നും ചോദ്യങ്ങൾ ചോദിക്കാനില്ല എന്നാണോ?
മാഡം, ലെറ്റ് മീ ഇൻട്രൊഡ്യൂസ് ദാറ്റ് ഐ ആം ഇസ്മയിൽ ആൻഡ് ഐ ഹാവ് എൻറോൾഡ് ആസ് എം എ സൈക്കോളജി ജനുവരി 2021 സെഷൻ 2021 സെഷൻ. എനിക്ക് അറിയേണ്ടത് എന്താ വെച്ചാൽ പറഞ്ഞാൽ ഈ എം എ സൈക്കോളജിയുടെ കൗൺസിലിംഗ് ക്ലാസ് തുടങ്ങുന്നത് എപ്പോഴാണ് എന്നാണെന്നുള്ളത്. ഞാൻ വിചാരിച്ചപ്പോൾ ഇത് ലിങ്ക് കണ്ടപ്പോൾ ഇതിന്റെ ക്ലാസ് ആയിരിക്കും കരുതിയത്.
ക്ലാസ്സുകൾ ഇപ്പൊ ഷെഡ്യൂൾ ചെയ്തുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുകയാണ് സർ. സ്റ്റഡി സെന്റേഴ്സ് ദേ ആർ ഷെഡ്യൂളിംഗ് ദ ക്ലാസ്സസ്. ഓക്കെ, സോ യു വിൽ ഗെറ്റ് ദ ക്ലാസ്സസ് വെരി സൂൺ സർ.
ഓക്കെ 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 മാഡം.
ദ സ്റ്റഡി സെന്റേഴ്സ് ദേ വിൽ ഷെഡ്യൂൾ ദ ക്ലാസ്സസ്.
ഓക്കെ മാഡം.
Sir, in the meantime, if you want to check on the world online counselings, you can visit our Indira Gandhi National Open University Regional Center Cochin YouTube channel and then get be benefited.
If no one has any doubt, shall we wind up this session, madam?
If there are no queries, then we can wind up, ma'am.
Okay.
And Dr. Vijay Raghavan is not yet there. Something yes. related to examination can be shared, and then we can wind. Now he has logged in. Dr. Vijay Raghavan, you can tell about the term and examination so that we can wind up the session.
Okay, madam.
And any two students, if they are willing to say thank you, it's an opportunity for you. And what you are saying will be recorded and will be uploading. Tomorrow you can share it even during an interview of how you presented, etc. Okay, so be benefited of this session.
Okay, madam. For assignment, first of all, I will talk about the assignments. Assignment link for this June 10 month examination has already been uploaded. The students are also submitting. So you can submit through the link by using that RC Cochin website. It's available. So most of the candidate, those are submitted December 2020. It has been already updated, but something pending is there from the study center that will be also shut out very soon. So examination point of view, till now we didn't get it any information when it will be conducted. Whenever that information will be received from New Delhi SCD, then we will inform to all the students. So meanwhile, the students are requested to submit their assignments by using that link, which is available in the RC Cochin websites. So this is a thing, and most of the students, they have previously last 10 month examination before those are completed, their degree certificate we have been dispatched by post. Those are already paid the fee through the online while submitting the convocation purpose. So the degree, most of the degree certificate has been received by the student, eligible student, and they have communicated also through email. So that's the thing we are doing during lockdown time also for the student support service. As far as concern, with the student concern, we are doing all the things. And if anything, any doubt regarding assignment submission or examination, students are requested to raise the queries. So any doubt are there, students, any queries regarding the assignment submission and the examination, please write.
Sir, I think students don't have any queries as such, I suppose.
Okay.
Maybe we can thank you, sir, for the information given, sir, to our students. Can any one of the students give a thanks to our resource person? Can you please unmute your mic and say a vote of thanks? Any one of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Myself, yes, Akshay. Akshay. Okay.
Go on, Akshay.
Myself, Akshaynath, on behalf of everyone who joined in the section, first of all, I would like to thank Ms. Prasida Unnikrishnan and other RC coaching staffs who selflessly take their time for conducting an online section about COVID-19, a review of personal accountability towards precautions. Next, I would like to thank Ms. Dorothy Madam for giving such a warm welcome to all of us. We heartily appreciate Ms. Jalaj Kumari ma'am for explaining and understanding all about personal accountability towards precautions. And ma'am also included about some social issues like dowry, domestic violence, farming, etc. All total, I would like to thank everybody who behind this. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Akshay. Thank you so much. One more student can say the vote of thanks. One more, please. Any one of you, don't shy away. It's an opportunity for you. Please take it as an opportunity.
Hello, everyone. I'm Aisha. I'm a student of psychology, MA psychology. Ma'am, I would like to express my gratitude for taking up this topic, because this topic is like very relevant at this time when we are actually tired of taking precautions against corona, because we have been doing this for about more than a year now. So I sincerely express my gratitude to Jalaja ma'am and all the RC Cochin staff for taking this initiative. And again, the first person I would like to thank is Ms. Jalaja ma'am, of course, for doing such a wonderful presentation and for giving me the valuable tips like how to do normal things at home, like washing vegetables and other stuff, because these are things that we often don't care about much, or we take these things very lightly. So thank you so much, ma'am, for giving such precious information. Then I would like to thank Dorothy ma'am, our regional director. And last but not the least, Prasida ma'am and other staff at RC Cochin for the initiative. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Aisha.
Yes, thank you. So once again, on behalf of all my colleagues at Regional Center Cochin and Dorothy ma'am, Regional Director, Regional Center Cochin, and a very big thanks to all of you, all dear learners who have taken their time out of the busy schedule to attend the session. A very big thanks to all of you. And I hope you take home some message from this session and try and implement it practically in your life daily. So once again, thank you all for this, for your presence and interaction with all of us in this session. Thank you. So we can now leave.